Stone soup. One summer, an old man named Thomas decided to travel to his daughter and his granddaughter. He had not seen them in almost a year because their farm was a 3-week journey away on horseback. However, the weather was good now and he knew he could camp each night along the way. He set off with some blankets, clothes, and a pot for cooking, and as much food as would stay fresh for 2 weeks. He brought some money in a small leather purse which he tied to his belt for safekeeping. Thomas rode many kilometers each day. Each night he camped near a village where he would collect water to boil over a wood fire. After enjoying a hot, tasty supper, he would sleep contentedly under the stars. The food ran out after 2 weeks, just as Thomas had anticipated. He planned to buy supplies at the next town he reached, so he decided not to stop when night fell. Instead, he kept riding as far along the road as he could. Little did he know, a band of robbers lay in wait up ahead. They leapt out suddenly and seized Thomas's horse by the bridle, threatening to harm him unless he gave them all his money. His hands shook as he emptied out his purse, and the villains jeered him as they ran off with what was rightfully his. Shocked and dismayed, Thomas kept riding until he reached a small village the next day. He knocked at the first house he saw, where a man called Joe lived. "Yes?" asked Joe wearily. "I'm sorry to disturb you," said Thomas. "I'm far from home and I have been robbed. Can you please spare some food?"
"Times are hard," said Joe. "All I have are turnips and potatoes, and I can't afford to give them away for free. Sorry."
Evelyn, a woman living at the next house, shook her head sadly while Thomas told her about his predicament. "I'll be able to spare some food next week," she said, "once I've sold my crafts at the fair. Until then, there's only enough cabbage and pork for my daughter and me. We're tired of eating it every day, but it's all we have." Thomas was about to give up and leave the village when he had an idea. He went to a nearby river and filled his pot with water. Next, he plucked a grey, smooth stone from the riverbed. He placed the stone in his leather purse and then set about gathering as many sticks as he could carry. He returned to the village square and built a fire to boil the pot of water. The villagers were very curious about his odd behavior and they gathered around to watch. Thomas carefully uncovered the stone as if it was precious and dropped it into boiling water.
"What's that?" someone asked.
"Oh, it's a soup stone," Thomas answered. "It makes delicious soup, you know." The villagers were intrigued as no one had ever heard of a soup stone.
"Can I taste the soup when it's ready?" asked one.
"You're welcome to try it," said Thomas. "It's just a shame that I don't have any vegetables to put in it so I can make enough for everyone."
"But I have some potatoes and turnips," exclaimed Joe.
"I have carrots," said another man.
"Cabbage is nice in soup," said Evelyn, "and so is pork."
The villagers ran to get their meagre ingredients, which Thomas happily added to the broth. After a while, such a heavenly smell filled the air that the villagers could hardly wait for Thomas to dish up the soup. They all chatted and laughed together as they ate the stone soup. They all chatted and laughed together as they ate, and the stone soup filled their stomachs and warmed their hearts.